low amplitude turnover. Appropriate selection procedure applied in the recruitment process ensure that only the most qualified individual is chosen to fill up vacancy. So that means the meaning of the why we are considering the low employee turnover is the importance of the selection, because through the selection procedure, because the applied, those who applied in the recruitment process, so that is not ensured that only the most qualified individual is chosen to fill a vacancy basically. So through that we can easily, it will not take too much time, it will help in low employee turnover, because the recruitment process ensure that only the qualified employee, only the skilled employee is chosen for a fill up vacancy basically. Next, assist behavior. Selection gives managers an opportunity to assess potential employees' character and personality. Assist behavior. Selection. So the, on the behalf, what are the criteria on the behalf of that employee will be selected? That means the manager given an opportunity to assess, to identify, verify the potential employee characteristic and the personality. So according to their character and the personality, employee will be selected in the organization. The time dimensions. A good selection procedure saves time in the recruitment and orientation processes, because the applicant is expected to have been introduced to some aspects of the organization culture, such as the dress code. That means the, what are the time dimension under that? These are the procedure that also save the time in the recruitment. Orientation process, because the applicant, those who have the expectation about the introduce, about induction, in the induction program, about the introduce some aspect, what are the organization culture, rules, regulation, policies. So according to them, what are the dress coded, what is the timing, and what are the criteria on which basis they have been selected. So this is the time dimensions. These are the importance. Aspects of employee selection. So what are the aspects involved? On that behalf, the organization will select the employee. First, the application blanks, life history, work history, references, recommendation letter. What comes under the application blanks? In the application blank, it is a most commonly used to collect information from the applicants. The information sought and information provided will facilitate the selection process. The information sought in application blank may vary according to the position and the organization. So mostly application blanks seek the following types of the information. That means in the application blank is like that, ki what type of the information is required from the applicant. So that will provide the facilitate and the, in the selection process. So these information provide according to the position and the organization. So what type of the information is provided? This is the, like you can see the applicant blank form. This is need to fill by the particular employee. Like what type of the data is required? Personal data, their marital data, educational data, physical data, employment data, extracurricular data, and the references. When an applicant submits his application blank, he provides a brief bio data about himself to the organization. Like in the brief, he or she has to mention about the personal data, marital, education, what is the qualification, any physical data, employment data, references, all the things man provide in a brief to the organization. It facilitates comparison among the applicants. So through this, the applicant blank, the manager can comparison the form, comparison also among the applicant. It serves as a basis to initiate a dialogue in the interview. It that means that serve also like what type of the These are the criteria, and this type of the information is collected from the employee by the application. Life history. Life history is the overall picture of the informant's interviewee's life. That means in the life history, that means they have to give the history about the interviewee's life technique. In both cases, the one doing the interview should be careful not to ask yes or no question, but to get the subject to tell the story of his or her life in his, her or own words. Whenever they want to ask about the life history, so candidate should be ready to carefully ask about what type of the question is there, not type like answering yes or no, but tell the story of his or her life in his or her own word. This is called the narrative method, like the short essay method. It is common practice to begin the interview with the subject's early childhood and to proceed chronologically to the present. Another approach, dating from the Polish peasant, is to ask participants to write their own life stories. This can be either through the competition, as in the Poland, Finland, or Italy, by collecting written life story written spontaneously in these countries. These are already large collection of life story which can be used by the researcher. Like in the organization, if the organization or the manager or the researcher wants to collect the life history about the particular candidate, so they can use this method. So through this method, they can write about their own life stories. They can also ask participants to write their own life stories. All the things are mentioned in there. So this is the way. This type of the way, this is the, we can say this is the competition. Like they can collecting, writing life story written spontaneously. Okay. So through that, these country already collection large type of the data, large collection of the history that can also be used by the researcher, obviously. Work history, because every organization should have the knowledge. If any employee have the experience, so what about their work history? Work history, also known as your employment history, is a detailed report of all the job you have had. Yani in the past, if any job they have had, so including the company name, job title, and dates of the employment. All the history, work history, which is the past related experience, have mentioned in this report. Employers review employment history to determine whether the jobs the applicant has held or not. If yet, yes, then their experience is a good match for the company's requirements. According to that, we can assume that, we can anticipate that employee skills, their participation in the company, and is he or she is good match for the company's requirement or not. We can find it through the work history. They will also look at how long the person has held each job. Many jobs of a short duration may imply the candidate is job hopper, those who wants to apply for the job and want to stay long if hired. So through that, we can know, we can easily identify, we can easily analyze about their work history, about their past job related data, like in which all the details mentioned, where they have done the job, with the time experience, their responsibilities, pay scale, and all the things. References. A references is a person who is willing to talk to potential employers about your job skills, abilities, background, and a general character. Hopefully, in a positive light, potential employers usually contact reference by phone or email. So, reference. Reference is like a person who has the willing, who has the power to talk to potential employers about your job skills, your abilities, the background, and the general character. So in the positive way, the potential employer usually contact reference by the phone, or through that employee, that through for that employee, organization can easily contact it by the phone or email. A letter of recommendation. Letter of recommendation is very specific in nature and normally requested and always addressed to an individual, whereas a letter of preference is more general in nature and usually addressed to whom it should be concerned. Letter of recommendation, after the all the process of the selection, like a letter of recommendation, it is a very specific in nature, whereas like a letter of reference is more general in nature, like this letter to whom it may concern, it's related to with whom, that's showing that because it is always addressed to an individual. Resume, CV's interview. This is the process. First, resume, it is started from the resume CV's review, screening interview, application blank, selection test, selection interview, medical examination, reference checks, and the hiring decision. So let's come to this. Selection process. Reception. A warm, friendly, and courteous reception is extended to candidates with a view to create a favorable impression. Employment possibilities are also communicated honestly and clearly. Whenever the candidate, selected candidate, received a call from the any company, organization where he or she has applied for the job, so with the respect, with the courtesy, with the friendly, the candidate is welcome at the reception of the organization, because it say ki first impression is the last impression. So employment possibility are also communicated with the honestly and the clearly. Screening interview. In the preliminary interview, it is used to eliminate those candidates who do not meet the minimal eligible criteria laid down by the organization. If suppose any employee who applied for the job, for the manager suppose, and he or she has only the BA qualification, so that type of the employee is not do not meet the minimum eligibility criteria laid down by the organization, so that employee should be eliminated from those candidates. The skills, academic and family background, competency and interests of the candidates are examined during the preliminary interview. In the preliminary interview, what type of the skill that a particular employee has, their academic background, their family background, what are their competency for doing a particular task, and what are their interested area of that candidate are verified during this session, this preliminary interview. Preliminary interviews are less formalized and planned than the final interview, because final interview should have lots of the planning, lots of the questions will be prepared rather than as preliminary interview. It is a very less formalized. The candidates are given a brief up about the company and the job profile. It is also examined how much the candidate knows about the company. Preliminary interview or also called the screening interview. So in the this is the basic interview. In this, the candidate has to give the brief introduction about what he or she is know about the company, about the job profile, and how much they know about the company. So this is the very basic question in the asked by every organization in the preliminary interview. So preliminary interview also called the screening interview. Application blank. After the screening interview, the application blank. The candidates who clear the preliminary interview are required to fill application blank. That means the candidates who clear this the first step, that means the screening interview, they need to require the fill all the information that you have mentioned in the application blank. It contains data record of the candidate about the basic information about their age, qualification, reason for if he or she has any experience. So what are the reasons for leaving previous job, any experience, etc. It is a printed form completed by the job aspirants detailing their educational background, previous work history and searching personal data in mention like the personal data, marital status, their qualification, any skills, any their hobbies, all the things in mention in the application blank that should be fulfilled by the required and the selected candidate. Selection testing. A test is standardized objective measure of a sample of behavior. That means in this test, the behavior of the employee should be measured. Selection tests are increasingly used by company these days because they measure individually difference in a scientific way, leaving very little room for individual bias. Because suppose if the organization showing the bias, favoritism regarding the any employee, so how can you fulfill the objective measure of a sample of the behavior? So various written tests conducting during the selection process like aptitude test, intelligence test, reasoning test, personality test. So these are the ways through that they can measure the individual difference in a scientific way. These tests are used to objectively assess the potential candidate. So through these tests, we can easily select the potential candidate. This should be not be biased. Intelligence test, aptitude test. So what is the intelligence test? They measure a candidate's learning ability and also the ability to under the instruction and make judgments. They do not measure any single trait but several mental abilities. So in the intelligence test, if the organization like what are the learning capacity, learning ability, also what are the level of understanding, any instruction is given by their boss, their superior, and how can they make the judgment on that instruction. So they do not measure only the single behavior but several mental ability like their memory level, their vocabulary, their fluency, the numerical ability and the perception. All these abilities are measured by this intelligence test of a potential candidate. Aptitude test. They measure a candidate's potential to learn clerical, mechanical and mathematical skills. Since they do not measure a candidate on the job motivation, they are generally administered in combination with other tests. They measure what are the potential candidates has the power to learn about the in the form of the clerical, mechanical, mathematical skills. So it is the test. Like they can find out the combination with the other test. Next, we have the achievement test. These are designed to measure what our applicant can do on a job currently. Whether the testee actually knows that he or she claims to know. So this type of the test, if any applicant can do on a job currently, like if the situation, if any situation occurred suddenly in the organization or any the task given or responsibility given to that particular employee, so how they do perform, can they do or not job currently. Simulation test. Simulation exercise is a test which duplicates many of the activities and problems on employee face while at work. Like suppose if any difficult task has given to any employee and they showed like two types of the employee maybe in this condition, they will give their 100%, they will try, or the third one is they don't have the interest in that particular work. So through that we can find out the activities, through the many activities, the problem that can show on the employee face during the work time. Personality test. They measure basic aspect of a candidate's what type of the personality any employee has, like the motivation, emotional balance, self-confidence, interpersonal behavior, and introvert. So what type of the behavior they have, what type of the aspect of a candidate has, through these tests we can easily identify. Projective test. These tests expect the candidates to problem or situation based their own motive, attitude, value, etc. Like this test, they can, if any candidates through the expectation, organization, if any candidates to the problem or situation based, like this type of the test, like suppose suddenly the fire occur in the organization. So what are their reaction? They will help to sort out the problem, or they will run away from the place. So through this test, we can identify the reaction according to situation. Interest test. These are meant to find how a person in test compares with the interest of successful people in a specific job. Like what are their criteria, what are their level of the interest would be with the interest of the successful people in a specific job. If suppose I am researching person A has the particular interest in this particular field, so I can easily find out the person, this person is capable for doing this work because he or she has a particular interest, specific interest in a specific job. These tests show the area of the work in which a person is more interested. Preferences test. These tests try to compare employee preferences with the job and the organization requirement. Preferences is like preference test means these tests try to compare employee preferences with the job and the organization requirement. What are the requirements of the organization and what are the preferences, what they are prefer, their priority towards the job. So they can compare both of through this test. Assessment center. It is a standardized form of employee appraisal that uses multiple assessment exercises such as in a basket, game, role play, etc., and the multiple criteria. So through these exercises, they can appraise their multiple assessment exercise, their standardized form of the employee, and they give the rating them. Selection interview. It is a one-to-one interaction between the interviewer and the potential candidate. So there is an interaction between the interviewer, those who will ask the question, and the potential candidates, on which basis it is used to find whether the candidate is best suitable for the required job or not. So these type of the such type of the question are asked by the interviewer to the potential candidates. Through this answer of the answer received from the candidate to find whether the candidate is best suitable for the job or not. But such interview consume time and money more. Obviously it will take too much time and it will be too costly also. Moreover, the competency of the candidate cannot be judged, because through that we cannot judge the employee competencies. Such interview may be biased each time, because it may be the bias. It will show the favoritism. Such interviews should be conducted properly. That type of the interview should be conducted properly in the properly the manner of the question. The interviewer already before prepare a list of the question. No distraction should be in their inner room. They're like, there is no distraction, any disturbance in the room. There should be an honest communication between the candidate and the interviewer. There should be no bias between the interviewer and the potential candidates in the selection interview. Types of the selection interview. The first one is the non-directive interview. The recruiter asks questions as they come to mind. Non-directive is like they didn't plan any question. What type of the question just come in the mind of the recruiter? As they come to mind, they just ask from the candidate. The directive or structured interview. The recruiter uses a predetermined set of questions that are clearly job related. If any job related question that should already be predetermined, that should already prepare in the fourth set of the questions that also ask from the candidates. The situational interview. The recruiter presents a hypothetical incident and asks the candidate to respond. Like suppose if any situation occur at the immediately at a present time, so any incident happen. So what are the respondent come from the candidate that can analysis to the situation interview. The behavioral interview. The focus here is on actual work related incident and the applicant is supposed to reveal what he or she did in the given situation. What are their behavior during the actual work that are related to the any incident. The applicant, the candidate that should be supposed to reveal what he or she did in a given situation. What are their behavior. Stress interview. The recruiter attempts to find how applicant would respond to aggressive, embarrassing, rude, and insulting at time questions. That means during the interview time, the interviewer can easily analyze at the time of the interview, at the time asking the question, employee is aggressive, embarrassing, or insulting. We can easily find out. The panel interview. Three or four interviewer pose question to the applicant and examine the suitability of the candidate. So in the panel interview, three or four interviewers will sit together and ask the question to the candidate and examine the what are the suitability. If he or she can match the job, if he or she is suitable for the job or not. Medical examination. After the interview, the next step is the medical examination. To check the physical fitness for the job concern, because every organization wants a healthy employee, physical fitness for the job concern, because if any employee has any problem, like any major issue, so obviously he or she will take the too much leave. So it will also distract the organization task. It will also create a barrier in the achieving the organization goals. To protect the organization from infectious disease, because like suppose if any disease that can be create a that not create a good environment, that create a infection, spread the infection in the environment. So that's why the organization is responsible for that. Why they hire that employee if they already know that employee particular has the infection disease? So the organization is responsible. So through the medical examination, the organization can protect the organization from the infectious disease. Medical tests are conducted to ensure physical fitness of the potential employee. How much the employee is fit or not. It will decrease chances of employee absentees. References checking. Contacting previous employers of a job applicant to determine his or her job history. In the references, if any employee give the references about the previous job, so the organization can check about their job history is true or not, whether it determines that he or she has worked there or not. Reference check may also include checking with the schools, the college attended by the applicant to verify educational qualification also. So through the reference, we can also check their qualification from the schools, colleges, and their vacancies attended by the applicants. Yes or no. So through the references, we can easily analyze the reference which is given by the potential employee in the. Now we have to take the decision, hiring decision, yes or no. Congratulations. If the organization have been selected, that means you have a new employee. Congratulations. Skills of an interviewer. Interviewer is who take the interview from the interviewee. Be prepared. That interviewer, be prepared. Make the candidate comfortable. It's not like that it's showing the attitude, it's showing in a proper manner. That make the candidate comfortable. Be consistent with your question. Like what type of the question you are asking, that should be the consistent. Be consistent. Learn about the candidate. So through the interview, the interviewer can also learn about the candidate, about their personality, their behavior. Be conversational. Like they have to, if suppose interview is not asking, he or she is showing the hesitation. So be conversational with them. Be flexible with your question. Work on your listening skills. So interviewer also work on the listening skills, because all the answer that is answering by the candidate, that should be the recording. Act naturally. So it's not like I am the interviewer, so I am acting like I am the king of this organization, and also act naturally with the interviewee. Don't worry if there is silence. If suppose in the some time the employee, the candidate, that means the interviewee, giving the interview and it's showing the, like he or she is showing the hesitation, he or she doesn't know about the answer of that particular question. So don't worry. If there is silence, ask appropriate question with the interviewee. Don't make the interview about you. Like it is not like that he is asking the question from you also. Make the candidate curious. Curious is about like asking the curiosity, what will be happen, how to do, and all type of the make that situation, make the session this type of things. Listen from non-verbal language. It is not like listen for the non-verbal language, not for the verbal. Look for real solution. So what are the real solutions that can be taken by the organization? So look, focus on that. Follow up with the candidate. So also the follow up with the candidate, like what type of the skills of the employee. Follow up with the candidate, all the questions, like if you think that this employee is suitable for the organization, so you have to follow up with the candidate. Barriers to effective solution. Selection. First, we have the ineffective recruitment. Sometimes selection process gets affected due to ineffective recruitment initiative. Like suppose if any business focus by the organization or by the manager, so it will create the barriers. It will create the barriers to ineffective selection. If the recruiter fails to attract qualified candidates in the recruitment process, then it obvious the right candidate will not be selection in the selection process. If suppose recruiter, the person, the manager who has the qualification, the proper qualification, he can also be suitable for the job, but he does not continue that employee with the selection process, so obviously the candidate will not be selected in the selection process. So therefore, ineffective recruitment will definitely influence the selection, because the selection is based on the recruitment. Perception. Our inability to understand others accurately is probably the most fundamental barriers to select the right candidate. Selection demands an individual or group to assess and candidate comparing competency of others. Like our inability to understand other accurately is probably the most fundamental barrier to select right candidate. If what our perception towards selecting the right candidate, selection demands is like the individual group to assess the candidate. They can compare and they can easily find out the right person for the right job at the right place. This is the procurement. But our views are highly personalized. We all perceive the world differently. Because if I am taking the interview, so I have a different perception. I perceive all the world differently. Someone perceive all the world differently. So our limited perceptual ability is obviously a stumbling block to the object and rational selection of the people. So the perception is also the barriers. Like if I have the perception regarding any candidate, so it will also create the barriers to effective selection. Gender issue also hampers effective selection. In early days, men predominantly held managerial jobs. If those jobs are viewed as being primarily masculine in nature, such stereotyping may produce negative reaction in selecting right candidate. So it is not like that only man can do this work. So this type of the bias should not be shown by the organization, because it may produce a negative reaction on the selecting a right candidate. If any female is giving the interview, so it will not create the good perception towards the organization also. So gender issue is also the barrier to effective selection. Age, race issue. In many selection, age, race of the candidates are considered rather than their skills, ability, experience. These lead to bias selection. Like suppose if the fresher, he or she has to start it from somewhere. It is not like that he or she should have the experience. Okay, so we are not considering their skills, ability and experience, but we are focusing on the age. So obviously this leads to also the bias selection. Halo effect. Another barrier to selection is halo effect. What is the halo effect? Which can be negative or positive? That is depend on that. Halo effect, the personal characteristic influence or overwhelms the interviews, and this leads to wrong selection. That means the one characteristic effect on the all characteristics, all overall the personality of the person. So this will also lead to the wrong selection. Quota system. What is a quota system? Quota system also influences effective selection fairness. Selection require that no individual should be discriminated based on their, like, any religion, race or gender. Like there is a no quota system, should be no quota system in the job. But the less number of women and other less privileged selection of society in the middle and the senior management positions and open discrimination in the job advertisement in the selection process would suggest that all efforts to minimize inequity have not been very effective. Because this quota system shows that there is no equity. You are showing the bias. Okay, so the quota system is the another factor that also the barriers of the effective selection. Validity. The extent to which the technique measures the intended knowledge, skill or ability in the selection context, it is the extent to which scores on a test interview correspond to actual job. Like what are their knowledge, skills or ability that shows that what are their criteria on which basis the organization will select you? What are your validity? That is based on the actual job performance. Reliability. A reliable method is one which will produce consistent result every time it is conducted. That means the consistent result that should be conducted, like a reliable method, that is a one like through that we can validate tests, we can reliable tests, we fail to predict job performance with the precision. Like the how the employer is reliable for doing a particular job. So through that validity test, reliable test may also the fail because we cannot analysis. We can select the employee on the basis of the things like their knowledge, skills, ability. We cannot show the reliability because it may also fail to predict job performance with the precision. Pressure. This occurs when politicians, bureaucrats, relatives, friends, and peers try to influence on the selector to pick particular candidates in public sector. The barriers mostly influence a good selection. Like suppose if any, if you have any pressure like from the society, politician, or the bureaucrats, or friends, so that also try to influence on the selector for picking a particular candidate. Why pick a particular candidate? Organization should be always choose or select those candidates who will suitable for the particular job, not for like the showing the bias, but for the favorism. So this barrier most influence a good selection. Next we have the nepotism and the favorism. This is the one major common barrier to effective selection in both public and the private sector. Like favoritism shows that the bias also. So those other, what about the others? So this will nepotism and favoritism should be end up because it's also create in the not in like the private sector, also in the public sector also. Cost and time. Sometime due to insufficient time and the budget, right person cannot be selected. So this is the another barriers we can see. So these are the barriers that should be avoided by the organization while the during the selection time. So they can select the right candidate at the right time for the suitable job that will also give the 100% that are also suitable for achieving the organization goals. Thank you.